Hello, and welcome to Aesop Grimm's Chronicles, where the emphasis is on immersion and storytelling. While some games contain mature themes or language, you can expect clean commentary from me as a narrator. Additionally, I will provide a content summary in the intro video for each chronicled series, so no one is blindsided or surprised. Let's play a story.
Welcome, everybody. I am Aesop Grimm, and this is the intro video for our Subnautica Chronicle. Let's go ahead and roll out the content briefing. The ESRB rating for this game is E for everyone. That's everyone 10 plus is what that means. It's marked for fantasy, violence, and mild language, and the rating summary says that this is an adventure game in which players assume the role of a survivor on an aquatic alien planet. From a first-person perspective, players explore an open-world environment, search for resources, and interact with the planet's aquatic wildlife and alien species. Some species may be hostile and can attack players in their submersibles. Players can ward off attacks by using knives and torpedoes. The words damn and hell appear in the game. Okay, on a site that I'm really beginning to appreciate, commonsensemedia.org, Subnautica, in a write-up written by Mark Saltzman, is rated as age 11 plus, given 4 stars. He says it's gorgeous, challenging, atmospheric underwater thriller. And What Parents Need to Know says, parents need to know that Subnautica is an adventure game. After crash landing on a planet, you're tasked with exploring mostly underwater areas, finding items you can use, such as crafting things you need for survival, staying alive around threatening creatures, and uncovering more of the story. There's some fantasy violence, such as using your knife to attack fish-like creatures, and there are some scary moments, too, for parents to be aware of. There are also some instances of damn and hell and dialogue. Okay, I think that does a good job of giving you a heads up on the content for Subnautica. I believe you can make your decision from there, and I've provided enough information. Moving on then to the next part of the intro video, and that's just kind of setting up what Subnautica is to me, what I plan on doing with this playthrough. Well, honestly, Subnautica is the catalyst point for me. Whenever I kind of finally got the time in my life and the space, the life circumstances where starting a YouTube channel and putting and documenting games became a real possibility for me, Subnautica was the game that kind of, like, I was playing it and I'm like, man, I would love to have this up on a YouTube channel. And so I started digging into it, and it was the catalyst point for me kind of learning, how do I record videos? What software do I need to get? I had to go through the learning curve for OBS software. And then what happened is I was not able to record Subnautica at the settings that I wanted to. And I really had to learn. It was a long process to figure out, is it my machine? Or is it the settings I have in OBS? I learned a lot of stuff about OBS settings. I learned about how recording works, how much stress it puts on your system, whether it's CPU or GPU related. And it turned out that it was both. It was a little bit of my recording settings, and it was a little bit that my system just wasn't quite strong enough. My system could play Subnautica at the highest settings by itself. But whenever you recorded also with the settings that I wanted in the game, you know, that was like the straw that broke the camel's back. It just went over the threshold. So that led to me building my system up. It led to me moving up into 4K gaming from 1080p. Something that I would say is my new threshold. I'm kind of barely at that threshold. It's not the same. Before, my threshold was just below being able to record 1080p full everything in the settings at 60 FPS. Now, with an RTX 2070 Super, I've been able to record most games, most of the kinds of games that I play, at 4K 60 FPS. But it's close. It's close. And some of these games, I need to take a dip in one of my graphical settings on one or two things in order to give it enough headroom, you know, et cetera, et cetera. But for the most part, I've been able to play and record at 4K. Okay. So that's why Subnautica represents something for me here. And I've wanted so bad to document a live playthrough of this series, like what we call a blind playthrough, that I haven't touched Subnautica since then. I mean, I've jumped in and I've tried to do recorded series here and there on a number of occasions, and something would mess up here or there. Or I would find out, okay, my settings are wrong, or in one case, I think I accidentally deleted my audio stuff and I had to go back and relearn how to do my filters. And then, so I've been in the game a little bit, you know, but I haven't progressed very far in the game. And I kind of stop. How am I trying to put this? I guess I'd just give you the skinny. I'm giving too much explanation here. I have not been very much past the Aurora for this game. I've been out, for example, I've been to the floating islands. Barely. Like, dipped in, saw a bone shark, and was like, nope, and dipped out. So I've been that far, and that's it. That's it. I built a base in the Mushroom Forest. You know, that's probably really, the Mushroom Forest is what I would consider really is the extent of my gameplay. Because I really did just dip in and dip out of the floating islands biome. So there's a lot of this game I haven't uncovered yet, and I want to capture that in this playthrough. I'll let you guys know when we start getting to things that I've not seen, you know. But it's a great game. I've really enjoyed it. I think it's a game that I'm going to try and role play a little bit. I don't know if I want to use that word, because I don't want to give the wrong insinuation here. I'm going to try and think about how our guy feels. I'm going to try and really put myself in his flippers as best as I can and think about what's going on around him and what kind of an impact that has. And maybe there's going to be times that they'll give us an input and I'll be like, wait a minute, you know, does that really give enough of an explanation? And I might come up with some additional fill in the blank stuff for myself just to try and further understand what this dude's dealing with, right? And that's the plan. We'll see how it goes. I am trying to do a 4K playthrough here. So far, I haven't run into any encoding errors. It seems to be doing fine. And we'll see, I guess, where it goes from there. I don't really have anything else to say. I'm excited about playing the game. I think it's a terrific game. It's a good plot line. It's creative. It fits well with the other stuff. I've been on a kind of a space kick here lately, and there are other games I like to play. I just haven't gotten through all the space stuff that I want to do first. And this is yet another game that I've not ever played through, where whenever I start to record it, it provides a different sense of motivation. And I think that has been successful in past recordings that I've done now, where I've gotten all the way through a game. And I'm anticipating that it'll be the case here as well. We will play this to completion, and I'm excited about taking that journey. So I will see you guys then in the next episode, where this story will begin. Y'all take care.
Thanks for visiting Aesop Grimm's Chronicles. If you've made it this far in the video, please consider rating, commenting, subscribing, and sharing. I hope to see you in the next episode, and until then, stay shiny.